Welcome back to CUM, College Online Ministry and Encouragement. I'm Reverend Jewel Williams here with our Wednesday Word for March 23rd. Our theme for the year is Enter God's Rest, Time for R&R, Release, Renewal, and Restoration. And our lesson for the month is What Have You Come to Do? We're doing part three, Jesus Overcame the Temptations. If you desire to know more about our ministry and our schedule, you can go to our website, williamsinnovativenetwork.webly.com. Our scripture theme for the year is found in Titus 3, verses 4 through 6. But when the kindness and love of God, our Savior, appeared, he saved us not because of righteous things we had done, but because of his mercy. He saved us through the washing of rebirth and renewal by the Holy Spirit, whom he poured out on us generously through Jesus Christ, our Savior. And so we're going to go back. Last week we read from the scripture Luke 4, starting at verse 14. But I'm going to step back to 4, verses 1 through 13. Let's have a word of prayer, and then I'll read the scripture. Lord God, we just ask that your spirit would rest, rule, and abide with us. We ask that you would just have your way. Lord, we ask that you would take over this time and that you would open up our understanding and that you would teach us. And we come willingly and humbly to receive from you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Starting at verse 1. Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, left the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. He ate nothing during those days, and at the end of them he was hungry. The devil said to him, "If you are the Son of God, tell this stone to become bread." Jesus answered, "It is written, man shall not live on bread alone." The devil led him up to a high place and showed him in an instant all the kingdoms of the world. And he said to him, "I will give you all their authority and splendor. It has been given to me, and I can give it to anyone I want to. If you worship me, it will all be yours." Jesus answered, "It is written, worship the Lord your God and serve him only." The devil led him to Jerusalem and had him stand at the highest point of the temple. "If you are the Son of God," he said, "throw yourself down from there. For it is written, he will command his angels concerning you to guard you carefully. They will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone." Jesus said, answered, "It is said, do not put the Lord your God to the test." When the devil had finished all his tempting, he left him until an opportune time. And so let's just look right at what is going on here. Now, I talked about this in the first lesson, when the first Sunday on March 9th, the first one that I did. But I just want to go back and go a little bit more into details. Because remember, Jesus came for a reason and a purpose. And part of what the devil does for both here that we see with Jesus, but he does this with us as well, is if he can get us to be tempted, then we can move into those temptations and then we can lose track of why we're really here. Now, the first thing that the devil tempted Jesus is into being relevant, to being important. And he says to him, "If you are the Son of God." And Jesus answers every assault of the devil with the word. And Jesus' answers to him was, "It is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God." And what do you say when the devil tempts you by saying, "If you are a child of God"? Do you give in to that temptation to show your importance by going after to things that, you know, as here it was that decaying bread? Do you go after those things that are decaying? What do you do when he tries to trick you into giving away the greater portion of what God has for you for the trinkets and false gold? He tempts us by saying, "If you were a child of God, you would be able to do this great thing or that great thing." Do you give in to the temptation, begin to try and prove yourself, or do you counteract him with the word? Do you tell him, "I am because he is, therefore I will be what he says I am"? I will not fall for your lies of relevance and use what God has placed in me for stale bread that is decaying. Instead, I will feast on the bread of life that never grows old, stale, or useless. I will live by the word of God. Do you speak the truth over yourself when the enemy tries to come and make you think that you have to show that you're relevant? And that's just really a trick that he uses with many of us. But we have to remember, it is not in the stuff that decays, the stuff that we're running after. We can eat that bread for a moment, but we have to go after the living word that always lives. And then the devil tried to tempt Jesus to be powerful. And Jesus answers again the word with the word. He puts the devil in his place. He tells him, get behind me, Satan, for it is written, you shall worship the Lord your God, and him only shall you serve. What do you do? Do you give in to the temptation, begin to try to build your own kingdom? Do you begin to promote the false trinity of me, myself, and I? You know when you're trying to create an empire for yourself, because it's all about you. You know, what has anybody done for me? What do I get out of this? How is this benefiting me? When we're in that kind of place, then we've moved away from the true God. And are you trying to create your empire because it's going too slow for you? See, the enemy tries to tempt us. Oh, well, you know, you can get to power yourself. Don't wait on God's time and create your own time. Or do you counteract with the word and say, this life is not about me. I am a worshiper. And I was created to worship. I'm going to be clay. I'm going to be moldable. Shape me, mold me, create me as you desire. In other words, God, I'm in your hands, and I'm allowing you to shape me in whatever way you want to shape me. It's not about Jewel. It's not about you. And that's what the devil wants to do. He wants you to get tempted into being about creating your own name, your own ministry, your own empire, because then you forget why you were really created to be here. The devil tempted Jesus to test God. And Jesus again answered the assault with the word and said, it has been said, you shall not tempt the Lord your God. What do you do when you're tempted? Do you begin to allow the enemy to trick you, or do you stand firm and trust where God has brought you to and how he will see you through? Do you trust him? Do you believe that God is capable of helping you, that you don't have to fall prey to the things that the enemy has brought your way? Because really, if you think about it, it said that he came when Jesus was hungry. The enemy often is coming after you when you find yourself in that place where you're hungry. And what are you hungry for? Are you hungry for being relevant? Are you hungry for being important? Are you hungry for those kind of things? Because that's the place where he'll come and hit you and attack you, in those places where you're hungry, in those places where maybe you fasted from. So he will try to come and attack you for those places where you've given up some things. So he'll try to bring them back and try to make them the place where he'll try to set you up for failure. But see, Jesus did not succumb to the temptations. In fact, he overcame the temptations. And the good thing is, if Jesus overcame the temptations, he overcame the world. So you and I can overcome them as well. So what have you come to do? Have you come to live as God called you to live? Have you come to stay focused on what he's called you to stay focused on? Don't get distracted with the things that the enemy comes to bring you away. Don't get distracted with the things of life. Don't get distracted, because see, ministry is not about me in the industry. Ministry is not about building your name, building your brand, even though you hear that often said. Yes, there are certain things that you have to do, but that is not really about you. There's things that we do to promote or advertise, you know, businesses and things like that, even your websites and things along the line. But still, even when you're doing the promoting, you still have to remember what you're promoting and why you're promoting. Because the enemy could get you caught up into thinking that this brand is about you, but this brand isn't about you. It's about God. It's all about him. And so we have to stay focused. Don't let anything get you tempted to lose focus on what God has sent you to do. Just as I'm taping these messages, and I believe God has called me to do this ministry online, but I have not forgotten that it's not about Jewel. Oftentimes when I do these things, I don't know who they're going to touch. I don't even know if they're going to make sense to you when you listen to them. That's my prayer. I leave it all up to God, because the bottom line is, I can't do anything for you. I can't touch you. I can't move you. If God is not in this, then I'm really just wasting my time. And so it has to be where my focus stays on being about what God has sent me to do. He's not sent me to promote me. He sent me to promote him. And so I try to make sure that my messages, my prayers, everything I do are focusing us back on the key thing, that it's all about Jesus. So today I just pray and ask you, what have you come to do? Are you getting about God's business? Have you got things right with him so that he can encourage you and equip you to do what he's called you to do? And then when he sends you out, know that you're going to go through a wilderness, a development process first, Because God wants to make sure you're able to overcome those temptations so that you're able to do the work that he's called you to do. Let's have a word of prayer. Lord, we thank you. Father, we pray that you equipped us and help us to be able to do the work that you've called us to do, that we keep our mind focused so that the enemy can't come and try to tempt us in those places where we might be hungry, or those places where we may have given up. And now we have, because we've given up some places, he's going to try to come and tempt us. But Father, help us. Give us the word, as we often saw Jesus spoke the word. So we know that our greatest tool is the word. So help us to be believers of the word, livers of the words, and doers of the words, so that we're not deceiving ourselves. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you.